In an ordinary home in Monterey Park is a koto that has languished there so long that it has become a dusty part of the decor. An assignment in the digital histories class sparked a renewed interest in it. As I looked at the koto and its accompanying pieces with a new perspective, it seemed to be calling out for some long-lost answers. And so the search began. The first question that needed clarification was, where did it come from? And how did it come to be here? I knew it had come into my father's possession sometime during World War II. Dad, do you remember this koto?
Yes, I sure do.
Can you tell me the story about how you got the koto and when you got the koto?
Well, when the war broke out, we were evacuated to Manzanar Relocation Center, and I was volunteering, and I was helping them load their luggage onto the bus. The gentleman had the koto with him. He was one of the first ones that was being repatriated to Japan, and he had the koto. He was carrying the koto, and I was carrying his luggage so we could put it on the bus. And then when the soldiers saw him carrying the koto, they took the koto away, because the only thing he could take to Japan was what he was supposed to carry, and I was carrying his luggage. And he was carrying the koto, and the soldiers took the koto away from him, and then handed it to me. And he was going to destroy it. When the soldier took the koto away from him, and he cried and said that, please let me take the koto back, because this is a family heirloom, and he wanted to take it back. And the soldier said, no, he cannot take the koto back. And he cried and cried and cried and said he wanted the koto to be sure that it wasn't destroyed. And so I said, I'll take care of it, and I'll make sure that no one destroys it.
So what did you do with the koto?
I took it back to our building, and we very, very carefully kept it until the war ended, and then we brought it back to Los Angeles. And we were in a small apartment, so we could not keep it, so we took it to my in-law, my Muraoka's garage, and stored it in the garage until we were able to take it home. And when our daughter Patty was old enough, we gave her the koto.
The koto was not destroyed or damaged. It had a few minor bruises. It had just leaned against the wall, both covered and uncovered, for many years. It was time to find out more about the care of a koto and possibly what should be done with it. With some research through the internet and help from several people, some questions have been answered. My friend Patricia tracked down a gentleman in Montebello that could restring it. From him I learned that it was valuable because it was made of one piece of wood and that the strings were silk. With some minor repairs and replacement of the end cloth, it could be restrung and played. Johnny Mori of the Aritani Theater took an email and passed it on to another source. The Japanese Museum gift shop suggested someone as well. From all of these people and other sources, I have learned that the bridges are ivory, and the box and second set of bridges are all made of the same wood. The cloth cover is cotton and silk, and the pick are again ivory and leather. Inside the koto was a newspaper that was dated November 13, 1937. Someone truly loved this instrument. It had been passed down to me intact. I'm not sure where the journey will take me with this koto, but I will honor an old man's request that it be treasured.